introduce yourself for the tape?
My name is Jean-Yves Picard. Jason Buddha for short.
Why don't you go ahead and introduce yourself?
I don't really believe in introductions. I think the first step to meeting a human being and knowing who they truly are is shaking their hand. So, yeah, please. Let me. Nice strong grip there, son.
Alright, so please state your name for the record.
Jaundice.
Isn't that a sort of like skin disease of some kind?
To you, it might be.
Would you please state your. Are you good? You can do it? Okay, could you state your name for the record?
My name is Joe Biden.
Can you give your real name for the record?
Mark. No last name, like Madonna.
The thing about shaking a hand is, instead of just an exchange of meaningless words, you have an exchange of palpable human energy through the fingertips, which the Greeks used to talk about were the most powerful parts of the human body.
Right, where are you from?
Harmony Falls, Oregon. It's a big Australian community, that's why I have this accent.
I'm looking it up here, and it says that Harmony Falls, Oregon was destroyed in a mining accident in 1362.
So we lived underground after that. It's a mining town where we unearthed rare dinosaur bones.
Can you also talk about your education a bit? I realize you have a bit of a unique background in that sense.
Yeah, I went to the Harvard School for the Thug. It's a 6-week course. It teaches you the basics of Glocks and whatnot, the various utilizations of the street weaponry. I shot the professor, so I got an A. It's the only one.
My education is the stars. Right? So basically what I just did there is I fooled you into thinking that the stars was a meaningful way of educating someone, right? That's called psychological warfare.
So you are admitting on camera to first degree.
I mean, it's part of the class. Like, you can't, like, it's a diplomatic immunity.
Did this take place in
the U.S.? Yeah, it was just Harvard, man.
Both of my parents were raging atheists, and they enrolled me in an anti-Christian school. Typically, you'd be in a Christian school of some sort, or, you know, I don't know what other religions exist.
You know, God made everything, duh, but, like, so what?
See, I was Scientology for a bit, and then I converted to atheism, and then I converted back to Christianity.
And the school was in the shape of the devil's sign, whatever that. I try to forget those dirty words. But yeah, those days they while personally for my own theology and spiritual needs, I was not fulfilled. I was fulfilled in other ways. By the great swim program they had at the school.
A lot of philosophers. I was very interested in philosophy from the age of 3 when my mother pointed at food and she said, you know, you've got to eat. And I said, why?
The year is 20. Jesus is born. We're just hanging out thinking it's all going to be fun and good times, but this freaking dude's got to say evil's bad. Where do I go from there? Answer that question for me.
You want me to answer the question?
I asked.
Well, this is more of like a, like we ask questions and.
It's philosophy, man. There's no questions. There's only answers.
Yeah, it's been hard, man. In 2003, I published a paper about why hedgehogs were more morally correct than humans were, and some people said that my study didn't exist, and they were right. It didn't. But it hurt.
Veganism is saying, you know, don't eat farm products, right? Why can't we eat humans? You know, you revolt. You get some humans in your body. It's a self-sustaining prophecy. You just keep eating yourself, but you're eating other people, and therefore it's veganism.
Have you ever personally eaten a human?
Yeah. some.
How was that?
It's fine. I don't know what to say. I mean, it's just like a normal human. What does a human taste like?
Now, these allegations about the Applebee's experiment, whatever they're calling it, Applegate or something like that, I personally don't see the use in criticizing a project that clearly has a lot of worth in it. I was simply trying to get to the bottom of how a Applebee's sampler, appetizer, whatever you call the word, could affect a man's perception on the outcome of an individual meal versus the overall conceptual prominence of an entree.
Paper. It's very interesting. What is paper fundamentally? So you have trees and then somehow they become paper? That doesn't make any sense. So look at the philosophical underpinnings of this. If God exists, God created paper, but then he created trees too? He's an idiot.
Are you okay, sir?
No.
Do you need a break? We can continue this another day if you need.
No. I drove here.
I'm sorry, what?
Are you okay?
What?
Modern philosophy has been facing sort of a downward trend because humans are not smart enough to understand my poetry.
You write poetry?
Oh, I do. I write many, many poems.
Do you have any poems you'd like to read for us?
Yes. Maximum velocity. Maximum velocity, maximum velocity, maximum velocity, maximum velocity, maximum velocity. That's about it. That's all I have.
What inspired that?
It's going pretty fast.
Describe the first time that you kissed a woman.
Well, to the philosopher, ownership is just a construct, right? So I figured, why not teach these people a lesson? Why not give them my own personal philosophical lesson? And I decided, what better way to do that than with taking military weapons and robbing a bank? I mean,
oh. You're a man of your word. Tell me a lie.
Well, the lie was in your statement already, so we've already covered that.
About the hammer, that's pretty close.
This bad boy's gotten me out of a lot of sticky situations, and it's blood sticky. Thor's dad was like, "Dude, you can make stuff, boom, 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 or you can destroy stuff." And so it's like, philosophy is kind of the same way, because you can make stuff up.
God, when he feels the time is right, he'll just boom, and you're gay.
See, to me, law and philosophy are intertwined. I think philosophy and murder are very close to each other in the academic spectrum. So I go around asking people philosophical and law questions, and if they don't answer correctly, I
the way I see it, cocaine's purpose is to open up the human mind to many different types of cocaine. I mean, heroin. I mean,
you kill people.
So, for the record, we have you on camera saying that you have murdered someone before.
Is that, are you joking?
That's correct. Do you have a number you can give us? Estimate?
Somewhere between 7 and 200.
Your book was titled The Ethics of Murdering People, and it seemed, at least to me, and I think most other people, that you were leaning in the direction of it is ethical.